In this video presentation, we're going to look at carrying out the continuity of CPC. We're going to include the polarity test, which got a slight twist on it this time, and then follow it with the insulation resistance test of this circuit here, a circuit we've mimicked to help us with our Sitting Guild's 5357 practical assessment. We have a consumer unit, and we have an industrial socket outlet, and we've fed it between it with a steel wire-armored cable, something that's required in our Sitting Guild's practical assessment. After installing our system, we're expected to carry out the dead tests, and this video is to help you with those dead tests. Remember to note for my learners that we've got a 16 amp industrial socket outlet, therefore the fuse within the consumer unit also needs to be 16 amps, and we've got an RCD rated at 30 milliamps for additional protection. We're going to set our tester up for that first test, continuity of CPC. However, it's actually the first part of the test is actually part polarity. We're going to test first of all between line and neutral, and then we're going to test between line and CPC, which will give us our continuity reading we record in the box heading R1 plus R2. On completing both, a test between line and neutral first, reading not recorded, followed by a reading between line and CPC, a reading that is recording, we will have completed the polarity test. Let's bring the camera in and see how we're going to set up the tester for the first part of this. So we're ready to set up our MFT tester, and this time we're going to be using our plugging lead that comes in the set of leads within the box itself. And as I said in the opening part of the presentation, we're actually going to carry out the first test between line and neutral as part polarity. So we're going to need both the blue and red connections on the end. And we're going to insert those in the top of the machine, remembering as it's a dead test, we're only going to use the red and green sections. So if I put my red one in and I put my blue one in, I will be ready to test between live conductors. I need to set my instrument onto the ohm scale. And I also need to be using this adapter in order that I can get into my 16 amp industrial socket. That requires this plus the original lead to have its resistance removed. Let's do that next. I'm going to plug in here, like so. So I've got both the lead and the adapter socket to have its resistance removed. I'm going to use crocodile link to link out my live conductors within my industrial plug, like so. And then I can see if I've got a reading. Okay, I've got a reading, need to remove that resistance. So I press the test button once. Notice it isn't flashing, so we are at zero at that stage. We're ready to carry out the first test, which is part polarity, testing between line and neutral. So my test instrument's all set up, ready to carry out the first part of the test, which actually is part polarity. So I'm going to need to remove the line conductor from the top of the breaker. So if I undo that, remembering that when you reinsert it later on, that you put it back to the required torque setting. So I'll disconnect my line conductor, and I'm going to link it, my disconnected line, to my neutral bar within my consumer unit. And I'm going to carry out my measurement then at the actual socket outlet itself. So let's plug in down here, like so. And I've got a reading of 0.15 of an ohm, a reading I don't record because it's part polarity. In order to complete the polarity test, we're going to test between the line conductor and the earth bar where the CPC is connected. On completing both stages, we will have actually completed polarity. In other words, we won't have an incorrect pin rotation in our actual socket itself. By proving two sets are in the right place, you actually prove that all three sets are in the right place, something we discussed actually in the classroom as well. So let's change it over. Remembering we need to change this over next. So we're back at the bench, and we now need to test between line and our circuit protective conductor. So if we remove the one that was measuring for the neutral, and we insert the green one, so we're now into the protective conductor. And let's just confirm that we have a resistance of zero on our actual lead and plug top. So if we go onto the earth pin, and then if we go onto the live conductor as well, let's make sure we get the right one. So we're on there. We've got a reading, we need to zero out. Oh no, we're at zero, so we're okay. So we're ready to carry out the next test, which will complete the polarity test and give us a reading we record as our continuity reading in ohms under the box heading R1 plus R2. So my test instrument's set up for the next test, the continuity of CPC. We're going to record this reading under the box heading R1 plus R2 in our test paperwork. And if this one's correct, we're also going to be able to tick the polarity box. So let's move our link across to the earth bar, remembering that we've changed our leads in the top, something we keep missing out. Let's plug in like so. And we've got a reading of 0.12 ohms, a reading that we're going to record. And as we've done two tests, line and neutral and line and CPC, we can also tick the polarity box. We're going to get ready in the next stage to do our insulation resistance test. So let's change our leads over in order to carry out the insulation resistance test. So let's remove our plug lead and get rid of that one. And we'll go back and insert our standard leads that we've used a lot in the workshop. So we've got our leads with the probes on. And we need to turn our instrument round to carry out our insulation resistance test, which is in the red scale. So we're up to 500 volts in the mega ohm scale in order to carry out the insulation resistance. So let's do that next. So remember, for the insulation resistance test, that all loads need to be removed. So we've got nothing plugged into our socket outlet and all covers need to be on. Can't put the consumer unit cover on, obviously, because we're testing from within there, but there are some precautions. Remember, we're going to need the breaker in the off position for us because we're using an RCCB, and we do not want the 500 volts under test to be passed through the RCCB as it contains electronic components. Doesn't matter which order we do it in. Remember, even Gaz hasn't got an order for this as long as we do the three sets. So we're going to clip on first of all to the neutral bar, and then we're going to clip on to the top of the circuit breaker itself. Press and hold our test button. We've got a reading greater than the machine can read, a greater than 999 mega ohms. Going to go across, going to go between the neutral and earth bar. We've got a reading greater than 999 mega ohms, and then we're going to move the crocodile clip across to the earth bar, and we'll test between that and the top of the breaker. And we've got a reading greater than 999 mega ohms. So that's completed the dead tests required for our steel wire armoured circuit for our industrial socket, a circuit that will be repeated in our Sitting Guild's 5357 practical assessment. Some other points of note on this installation that we'll discuss in the classroom is, we'll discuss whether we believe this requires connecting to the CPC, in other words, does it require earthing, and we'll have our discussions on that and discussions that we can then suggest when we're being marked practically that we believe possibly, so we're going to leave it there, that this wouldn't require connecting to earth because of how it's installed and what it's installed, actually we wouldn't earth it. However, the marking criteria in the Sitting Guilds and EAL assessments where tray is installed requires it to be connected to earth. We also haven't got a parallel earth path created between the metal enclosure here and this enclosure. This is a plastic enclosure, so we haven't got a parallel earth path created by the steel wire armoured within the cable. If we had, we'd have had to remove the parallel earth path when testing the CPC within the conductor. I've covered this in a previous video where I went between an isolator and a consumer unit as a sub-main feed, and both of those were metallic, and we removed the parallel earth path when we did that. So for this video, hope it's helped us out with our tests for our Sitting Guilds 5357, and I hope this video has been some help.